Would you like to stand, please? The first part of our funeral takes place at the door of the church, so could I ask you to turn and face the back of the church? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. And the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In the waters of baptism, Margaret died with Christ and with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. In life, Margaret cherished the gospel of Christ. May Christ now greet her with these words of eternal life. Come, blessed of my Father. In baptism, Margaret received the sign of the cross. May she now share in Christ's victory over sin and death. I'd like to say welcome to all of you who gather to say farewell to Margaret today. I'm sorry, I'm very emotional. I was very fond of you, Mum, as we all are. But Peter and Tim, it's lovely that you're here with your families. And Pauline, it's lovely that you're here with your daughter today. Pauline is Margaret's sister, come over from Ireland. It's lovely that you can be here with us today to celebrate her life, to give thanks to God for the gift that she was, and to pray that she will already be on her way to paradise. We come as Christians to remind ourselves of the promises of Christ, that our life is not ended but changed, and that after we die, we go to a new place prepared for us, and we'll hear about that in the gospel. And the signs around us are signs of that faith and that hope we have. The funeral pall is a reminder of baptism, and I sprinkled Margaret's coffin with holy water as she entered the church. The book of the Gospels and the crucifix are signs of a Christian life. And the Paschal candle, of course, we're still in Eastertide, but the Paschal candle stands as a sign of Christ, the light of the world. That light was given to Margaret when she was baptized, and that light shone brightly throughout her life. We were privileged to witness that. So we come to say thanks to God for her, and we come to pray for the repose of her soul, that she will already be speeding to paradise, which I'm quite sure she will be. We're going to sing our first hymn now. Tim is coming forward to say a few words of thanks. Would you like to take a seat?
Hello, everybody. Thank you for attending Margaret's funeral today. It means so much for all of us to see all of you here. Thank you too to Father Jonathan, the funeral directors, and all the mum's friends for their help and support in organising today, including the refreshments which will be available at the parish centre afterwards. Please do join us. It'd be lovely to see you there. Blessed Sacrament was a hugely important part of mum's life since she moved to Exeter in the 1960s. She was deeply involved in many different groups at the church and built lifelong friendships here via her time teaching at St. Nicholas. The family would like to thank all of you for the kind friendship and support that you've shown to Mum over the years. Thank you.
Would you like to stand? My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Listen kindly to our prayers, O Lord, as our faith in your Son, raised from the dead, is deepened. May our hope of resurrection for your departed servant Margaret also find new strength through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the virtuous are in the hands of God. No torment shall ever touch them. In the eyes of the unwise, they did appear to die. Their going looked like a disaster. Their leaving us like annihilation, but they are in peace. If they experienced punishment as men see it, their hope was rich with immortality. Slight was their affliction, great will their blessing be. God has put them to the test and proved them worthy to be with him. He has tested them like gold in a furnace and accepted them as a holocaust. They who trust in him will understand the truth. Those who are faithful will live with him in love. For grace and mercy await those he has chosen. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We'll remain seated to sing our psalm, Because the Lord is My Shepherd.
Let's be rest in the meadow and meet me to the choir.
reading from the letter of St. John. Think of the love that the Father has lavished on us by letting us be called God's children, and that is what we are. Because the world refused to acknowledge him, therefore it does not acknowledge us. My dear people, we are already the children of God, but what we are to be in the future has not yet been revealed. All we know is that when it is revealed, we shall be like him because we will see him as he really is. The word of the Lord. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. It is my Father's will, says the Lord, that whoever believes in the Son shall have eternal life, and that I shall raise him up on the last day. Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still, and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I am now going to prepare a place for you. And after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said, "Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Down. I visited Margaret on the Friday before she died, and took her Holy Communion and anointed her. And it was a very blessed moment. Linda was there, which was a great blessing as well. And then we decided that we would do some planning for today, which was very fortunate. And the first thing she said was, "I do not want a eulogy." So you will have to bring to mind your own wonderful memories of Margaret. And they are many, of course, because we knew and loved her. She was a member of this community, and I've been privileged to know her for the last 9 years. Excuse me. And not only was she a member of the community, she gave herself to the community. She was involved in so many different things. Of course, her tremendous work at St. Nicholas School, which remained with her. It was a legacy which all those who worked at St. Nick's hold very dearly. I know that there are a small group of people who meet up and are in regular contact, and it's such a wonderful thing, and she touched the lives of so many people. So we are grateful for that, along with everything else. The four readings, the four pieces of scripture we've heard today, remind us of what it is we're doing. That beautiful reading from the Book of Wisdom: "The souls of the virtuous are in the hands of God." we don't really need any more information, do we? We know that Margaret is in the hands of God. That's our faith, and that's why we gather today, to remind ourselves of these things. Margaret will already be experiencing that. She will be reunited with Joe and Michael and Claire in some beautiful way, and then we'll wait for all of us to join so that we can all be together in paradise. And that lovely psalm which we sang is the version of the Lord's My Shepherd, that beautiful image of the shepherd taking us to pastures new, where we can feast on the green grass by the still waters, where we will be at home, where the sun will shine, and it's such a beautiful image of heaven. The letter from St. John, his first letter, speaks of the love that God lavishes on us, and God lavished his love on Margaret. And that was not a love that's lavished so that it can be sort of absorbed by us. It's lavished on us so that we can lavish it on others. That's the whole point of the love that God gives us. It's a love that's to be shared. That's what the gospel is all about. That's what the whole of the Christian life is about. And Margaret did that. Margaret shared the love that she had received with all of us. It was tremendous. She knew people. She cared for people. She was particularly caring for me personally. She wrote me lovely little notes of support and kindness, and I'm immensely grateful and always will be. And in the gospel, that familiar gospel about the many rooms in my Father's house, well, Jesus wants to explain something about heaven, whether it's a pasture new or a house with many rooms. We need these images to help us at a time like this. We need these images to hold on to so that we can come to a deeper understanding of God's love for us. He has prepared a place for each and every one of us, and he comes back to take us to be in that place so that we can be alongside Jesus. So Margaret, today we hope and pray, excuse me, is already occupying that space, already occupying that place which she will call home for eternity. After Joe and Claire died, Margaret was really torn about moving. It was a really hard decision for her. I know many of you will be involved with conversations with her about that. Should she do it? I had many conversations with her. And she, of course, moved just down the road, and she was delighted that she was a little bit closer to church, which was wonderful. She could just walk up the hill. And it was a place that she did indeed call home. But now she's truly home. So we pray for the repose of her soul today. We pray that she's already enjoying all those beautiful benefits that heaven has for us in abundance. And we say thank you, Margaret. Thank you for everything you've given to us. Thank you for everything you've been for us. And we pray that if we could have a small percentage of the Christian example that she showed us, then we'll be doing okay. Would you like to stand? Thank you. God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and dead. For Margaret, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints. Lord, in your mercy. For our sister who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she may be raised up on the last day. Lord, in your mercy. For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness. Lord, in your mercy, for those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face. Lord, in your mercy, for the family and friends of our sister Margaret, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus. Lord, in your mercy, for all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom. Lord, in your mercy. In a moment of silence, we bring to God our own petitions. Lord, in your mercy. We ask Mary to join her prayers with ours as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed sister Margaret. Cleanse her and all the faithful departed of their sins, and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Thank you. And so we stand and pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look favourably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant Margaret may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended, and when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Margaret, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, for ever and ever. At the Saviour's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you, Pat. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Whoever believes in me, even though he dies, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will not die forever. Alleluia. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Margaret, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace through Christ our Lord. As Tim said at the beginning of this Mass, you are most welcome to come and enjoy the refreshments in the St. Richard Reynolds Centre. We'll be taking Margaret to the crematorium for the committal, but we will join you as soon as we can. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Margaret, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Margaret again and enjoy her friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. I know that my Redeemer lives, and on that final day of days, his voice shall bid me rise again, unending joy, unceasing praise. This hope I cherish in my heart, to stand on earth, my flesh restored, and not a stranger but a friend, behold my Saviour and my Lord. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Margaret, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Margaret in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and Margaret forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In peace, let us take Margaret to her place of rest.